Hey, what's up YouTube? In this video, I'll be showing you how to make this delectable looking gingerbread house. And if you like gingerbread houses, you might want to give this video a like, because legend has it that if you like this video, then a gingerbread house that looks exactly like this one will appear at the bottom of your bed when you wake up tomorrow morning. Well, I mean, it probably won't happen, but it's worth a go anyway. I'm definitely doing it. I'd really like to go for some gingerbread now. I love making these in real life, and it's almost as much fun to make them in Minecraft as well. Except, unfortunately, you can't eat this one, you can only look at it and live in it. If you do like this video, guys, please do consider subscribing to the channel, because you'll probably like all of the other content that I post as well. And if you do subscribe, not only should you say hello, I'd love to welcome you to the channel if you're a brand new subscriber, but you should also click the little bell next to the subscription button, and that'll make sure that you get everything sent directly through to your sub box. But I think that I've been talking way too long. Why don't I actually show you how to make this deliciously tasty looking gingerbread house? So, if you want to make it, here's what you'll need. Grab yourself some block of quartz, some red hardened clay, some redstone lats, some orange wool, yellow wool, lime wool, cyan wool, brown hardened clay, and some quartz stairs. Plus, we need every single other one of the other materials that you can see in the inventory right now, and we might even need more, because I always forget something, I always do. So, take a second, grab everything that you see, and once you have everything, and once you've figured out where you want to make it, and by the way, just to let you guys know, the actual house part of this build, the big house in the middle, not including the garden, the tree, the candy cane, any of that stuff that you saw at the start of the video, the house will occupy a space that is 17 blocks wide and 18 blocks long, or however you want to see it. It will fit in this almost square area below us. So you can actually see how big this is using the quartz and the light blue stained clay connecting. The house will fit inside those boundaries. So make sure you have enough room. Once you've figured everything out, you're going to want to kick off the house with this sequence of blocks coming directly up from the ground. You want to do one block of quartz, one red hardened clay, one block of quartz, one red hardened clay, one block of quartz, one red hardened clay. Now, do an upright diagonal using a redstone lamp. Then, do an upright diagonal using an orange wool. Do another upright diagonal using a lamp. Then do an upright diagonal using a yellow wool. Then do an upright diagonal using a lamp. Do an upright diagonal using a lime wool. Do an upright diagonal using a lamp. Then do an upright diagonal using a cyan wool. Then do a bottom right diagonal from that cyan wool using a lamp. Then do a bottom right diagonal with the lime wool. Bottom right diagonal with the red lamp. Then do a bottom right diagonal with the yellow wool. Do a bottom right diagonal with the lamp. Do a bottom right diagonal with the orange wool. Do a bottom right diagonal with the lamp. Do a bottom right diagonal with the red hardened clay. Then go down by one of the block of quartz, one with the red hardened clay. One quartz, one red hardened clay. And finally connect to the ground with one quartz. So you want to have something which should look exactly like that. So that is actually the frame of the front of the house. The back of the house actually looks the exact same, but we'll get to that in just a moment, won't we? So what we now want to do is this. Coming behind the very first block of quartz that we place, which is over here on the left, coming inwards, backwards, diagonally to the right, this block here, we want to place a brown hardened clay. So in this position, we then want to go right of that clay by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then do a row of 3 block of quartz. 1, 2, 3. Then do a row of 6 brown clay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, coming behind this 6th block, do a row of 15 brown stained clay. Coming back, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Then you can extend this row of brown hardened clay across the back of your house, and you can then connect it all the way to where you very first started with your brown hardened clay. So you will end up with almost a square. It's almost a square, it's just one block off. It's a rectangle though. So once you've got that sorted out, What we can now do is we can raise up each one of the brown hardened clays, and we can raise them up each by 5. And by the way, this is the corner blocks that I'm talking about. I said all of them, but well, we don't want to do that. We want to raise up the four corner blocks each by 5. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we want the same for all the rest. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this final corner as well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then you can connect all of them together at the top. So you can connect them together at the top, just going around like this, and it will form a nice box shape. And you're probably very quickly noticing how we are making the shape of the actual house. Like, this is the part where we have all of the windows, and we now have the front. Well, now that we've got the front, and now that we've got the basic shape of the house done, we want to come now to the back of the house, and we want to do on the back what we have on the front. So, basically, from either one of the back corners, we want to, coming outwards diagonally from the corners, we want to have a row of this. We want to, coming up from the ground, have a quartz, a red hardened clay, quartz, red hardened clay, quartz, red hardened clay. And now we want to replicate what we have on the front. So from this red hardened clay, I'm going to do an upright diagonal with the redstone lamp, then an upright diagonal with the orange wall, then an upright diagonal with the lamp, upright diagonal with the yellow, upright diagonal with the lamp, upright diagonal with the green, upright diagonal with the lamp, upright diagonal with the cyan wall, then a bottom right diagonal with the lamp, then a bottom right diagonal with the lime wall, then a bottom right diagonal with the lamp, bottom right diagonal with the yellow wall, bottom right diagonal with the lamp, bottom right diagonal with the orange wall, bottom right diagonal with the lamp, bottom right diagonal with the red hardened clay. We then want to go down with the block of quartz, then the red clay, quartz, red clay, and quartz to connect down to the ground. So we want to have something which should look exactly like that. Doesn't that look fantastic? Well, once you've got that sorted out, we're now going to add all of the things to the house that need adding. So the windows, the entrance, that sort of thing. So we'll do the back of the house first because it's the easiest. So first, the back of the house, we're going to want to fill the back wall in with brown hardened clay. So the back wall wants to be filled in with brown hardened clay because I didn't want any windows for the inside of the house, or at least the back of the inside of the house, because I want to be able to place things on the back wall. But what we also want to do is we want to fill in the space in between all of the lights, all of the wall, all of that stuff. We want to fill in the space with brown hardened clay. So just do a layer of brown hardened clay here inside of the back top part of the house, just underneath the roof. So from the outside looking in, you'll have something which should look like this. And how do you light those lamps, you might be wondering to yourself. Well, the way that we light the lamps is quite simply block of redstone. Place a block of redstone behind each one of the lamps. That's all you have to do for those ones. And they're going to be covered by stairs, so it doesn't really matter. And it's the same story on the front. So whilst we have the lamps out, you can also place the block of redstone behind the lamps like this. So light them all up, make it look all nice and Christmassy. Now, why don't we take care of the sides of the house before we do anything else? So we'll take care of the easiest side first, which is the right-hand side here. So on this side of your gingerbread house, we want to, starting from on top of this second row on the front, coming towards the back, we want to do this sequence of blocks. We want to do one red hardened clay, one block of quartz. One red hardened clay, one block of quartz. We then, still going right, want to do a brown hardened clay, then a red hardened clay, one quartz, one red hardened clay, one quartz. Then a brown hardened clay. We then want to do one red hardened clay, one block of quartz, one red hardened clay, one block of quartz. Like this. We now want to do this to each one of the windows. So starting from the left-hand red hardened clay, we want to do a block of quartz, red hardened clay, block of quartz. We then want to go right, red hardened clay, block of quartz, red hardened clay. We then want to go down, block of quartz, red hardened clay. You want to do that same thing to each one of the windows. So you want to form the shape of the windows using the same pattern that you've used quite a few times already. And this is of course, is simply the candy cane pattern. So we just want to have something which should look like that. And you can fill in between the windows with your brown hardened clay, like that. Now, we're going to need a couple more materials. We can get rid of the lamps for a while, and we're going to grab some quartz slabs and some white stained glass pane. Now, I'm going to fill in the windows with white stained glass pane, but you could equally fill them in with any sort of other material. I just seem to happen to like the white stained glass pane. If you want to balance something on the windows, do a row of quartz slabs across the top half of the bottom of the windows. Say, if you want to place like some flower pots with like little trees in them or something like that. Now, that is that side done. Let's head over to the opposite side and let's do what we need to do over here. So, this opposite side is actually different. We're going to begin with starting from the back of the house this time. Moving forward, you want to do going right, a block of quartz going right to the front, then a red hardened clay, block of quartz, red hardened clay, then do a brown hardened clay, then a block of quartz, two brown clay, one block of quartz. We then want to do a brown clay, then block of quartz, red hardened clay, block of quartz, red hardened clay. We then want to take the base of the windows, which you guys know that these are, and we want to form these into actual fully functional windows. So we want to do that. We want to take the windows and we want to form them into, well, big, square, nice looking windows. That is exactly what we're after right there. And now I'm just going to fill in this with glass. And once we've done this, you can add the windowsills if you so choose. You might not want them. If you don't want to balance anything on them, I wouldn't bother with them. I'm also going to fill in this side of the house in with brown hardened clay. And something that we're going to do on this side, and we should probably do it now before things get out of hand. We're going to take out the pillar quartz blocks, and we actually also need the quartz stairs. So here's what we need on this side of the house. You might have noticed at the very start of this video, this house has a chimney. Well, we have to add that chimney right now. The chimney is in line with where we have these two blocks of quartz in between the windows. So on the ground, in line with the blocks of quartz, we want to come up with the pillar quartz block and we want to do rows of 11 coming up. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And we want the same coming up from here. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I know that that first row is right, so no need to count it out again. We then want to extend the brown hardened clay in between these two pillar quartz blocks. We want to extend it upwards until it is equal in height with the pillar quartz block, and then it actually wants to go one row higher. Then on the inside of the build, we want to also have the same rows of pillar quartz block that come up. So we want to have the same rows of pillar quartz block that come up either side of the chimney. We want to place quartz stairs on the top of this, so we want to place quartz stairs on top of each one of the pillar quartz blocks, and we want to connect them together like that. We also want to have a row of stairs on top of the brown stained clay, so we want to have these stairs facing each other, or facing away from each other, right on top of this, with the brown stained clay. And as a matter of fact, maybe we can actually make the chimney look a little bit nicer. There we go. Maybe we can just knock out the stairs from the middle, and that looks a little bit nicer, I do think. And if you want, you can also add like little accents to the inside of the top, so you can add like upside down quartz stairs like facing towards each other just for the inside of the top, just to make it look a little bit nicer like that. And that is a very nice looking chimney, which will be utilized just a little bit later on. So once you've got that taken care of, this is what we're going to do next. So, coming to the front of the house, it's now time for us to add all of those little details on the front. So, on the front, first of all, we're going to take care of the windows. So, starting from on the left-hand side, on top of this left-hand row here, we're going to do, coming across to the right, we want to grab a block of quartz. And we want to do one red hardened clay, one block of quartz. One red hardened clay, one block of quartz, then one brown hardened clay. And then we want to leave this gap of three. Then we want to do a brown hardened clay, then a block of quartz, red hardened clay, block of quartz, red hardened clay. We then want to form windows out of these rows of four that we have. So form windows in the exact same way that you've done like four times already, I do believe. Maybe five times already. and there you will have the same windows that you have on these sides of the house. And once again, you can add windowsills to them, or you cannot add windowsills to them. It is completely up to you, as always, of course. So we're just going to fill these in with the glass, and we are going to then... I'll add the windowsills, and we can take them away later if we don't want them, but it really does depend. I'm going to then fill in just next to the windows with brown hardened clay, like this. I'm going to connect that together at the top. There we go. And now it's time for us to make the entrance. So I'm going to take this row of block of quartz that we have down here. I'm going to extend it forwards by one row. I'm then on top of this left-hand row, going to, on top of this left-hand block, going to place a red hardened clay, a block of quartz, red hardened clay. And now I actually need the quartz stairs and place that. Then going right, a red hardened clay, then a quartz stairs, then going down, a red hardened clay, quartz stairs, red hardened clay, connecting down. Then I'm going to come to the inside here, and if I want, actually I'm not even going to bother, I was going to say you can fill this in, but there's no point, to be honest with you. I'm then going to extend out this middle block here of the entrance. I'm going to extend this out, and I'm going to place a block of quartz either side of it. This is kind of like extra to the house, and we can also, if you like, place a door, and we can use our white glass. So I'm going to place a door here, and I'm going to place a white glass just above it, and that is going to be the actual entrance. Now I have to completely fill in the area just above the front of the house, so kind of how we did on the back. Exactly how we did on the back, actually. We want to have the front of the house filled in with brown stained clay. That's pretty much everything. We just want to fill this area in with brown stained clay, just so that when we look at it from the front, there we have a nice big empty frame. Now, above the door, we have a reef. That's made of jungle leaves, block of redstone, and some redstone lamps. So take the center block of the door, which is this, the redstone clay. We want to leave a gap of one, then we want to place a jungle leaf. Above that, we want to place a redstone lamp. Above that, block of redstone. Above that, a redstone lamp. We then want to place redstone lamps left and right of the block of redstone. And then we want to place jungle leaves going all the way around the blocks of the redstone lamp. So we want to have something which should look like this. Now, once that is taken care of, the next major part of this house, and possibly the last major part of this house, is actually the roof. The roof is easy and irritating at the same time, so it requires quartz stairs, some redstone lamps. It also requires pretty much every single wall that we have right here, so grab all of the walls. And we need quartz slabs. Let me show you how this roof works. So, we'll start with the easy side first, which is the right-hand side. We're going to take this red stained clay here at the top, where it then starts to go diagonal. We're going to place a quartz stair in front of it. We're going to extend this stair backwards, like this. And we're going to then take this row of stairs that we have, and we're going to extend it coming out in front of the build by one, either side, like that. Then we want to, starting from the very left-hand side, the front here, we want to knock out some of the stairs. So, for instance, we want to take this first one, and then we want to move inwards one, and we want to knock out the second stair. I'm going to place a purple wool in there. Then I'm going to move into the right, leave a gap of one, knock out the stair, place a lamp. I'm then going to leave a gap of two, knock out the stair, place a lamp. Leave a gap of one, knock out the stair, place the lamp. Leave a gap of two, knock out the stair, place a lamp. Gap of one, knock out the stair, place the lamp. Gap of two, knock out the stair, place the lamp. Gap of one, knock out the stair, I'm going to place a purple wall. So, you want to have something which should look like this. Can you see where the lamps are placed? Can you see the correlation? The correlation is that the lamps are placed above the corners of the windows, like this. So, this row has redstone lamps built into it. However, the next row of stairs, which is going to be placed one row above and one row inwards, has nothing placed into it. So we have no lamps, no anything built into that row. However, the row afterwards, in the same positions that we have like the redstone lamps and that we have the purple walls, this row, the row afterwards, leaving a row of one, we now want to knock out the same blocks that we have, just one row below, so we want to knock out the same blocks, and we want to place in these rows, we want to place in the empty blocks wool. So basically, we want to take each one of the empty spaces and we want to fill it in with wool. This can be using any wool in any order that you like. It is completely up to you what you want to have. I'm going to be following the simple pattern of using red, orange, yellow, lime, cyan, then purple, and I'm going to alternate. I'll show you what I mean by that. So that's that row filled in. Then the next row of the roof is going to be simply block of quartz stairs. The next row of the roof is simply quartz. However, the row after it, we're going to build in this time. We're going to build in the colors that we want. So here we have a red wall. So on this next row, I'm going to have an orange. Then I'm going to build in a yellow. You know what? It might actually be faster. I thought it'd be faster to build it into the roof, but I think it's actually going to be faster to make the entire roof in one go, and then we can just knock out the relevant blocks and we can place our wool in afterwards. So I know what pattern I want to use. I'm just going to fill in the entire roof using the quartz stairs, and then I'm going to knock in, and then I'm going to create the pattern. Like I said, I thought that it'd actually be a bit faster because we wouldn't have to like destroy them again, but I think it's actually going to be easier to knock them out and then do it. But so what we have now is like a nice big white roof, but that's not what we're after. So I'm now going to fill in the pattern. So I have to knock out all of these blocks, right? I have to knock out these blocks that the wall is going to be placed, and then I'm going to leave a row of one, a gap of one, and then I'm going to do the same thing to this row. And I just want, in the same positions, I want to have the same walls that are knocked out, or the same blocks that are knocked out. And there, so that means that this row is knocked out here. And then I can just simply figure out what pattern I'm going to use. I see here that I've placed an orange up front, so I'm then going to come back with a lime, cyan, purple. Then I'm going to rinse and repeat with the red, orange, yellow, like that. And then coming backwards on top of the next row, I've used an orange here, so I'm going to use a yellow on the next one, then a green, cyan, purple. Do you guys see the pattern? It's so easy. It's basically just following the pattern. You don't want the same two blocks to be used next to each other, and you just follow that same pattern along. So this would be green, cyan, purple, and then red, orange, yellow, lime, blue, and we just want to have something which should look like that, and that looks very, very nice. And there's something appealing about doing it this way, because it's like you can see that it's a pattern, and I don't know, it pleases the eye, or at least I like it. Now that's that side done, right? Let's move over to the other side, and let's do it on this side. So this side is ever so slightly different. We are going to begin once again. We're going to do the entire roof. And we're then, once we've done the entire roof, like once we've added all of the quartz and all of that stuff, then we're going to knock the pattern into the roof, because once again, it's got to be faster. It's got to be faster to add it after the fact rather than try and build it in, because there's way too much block swapping, swapping between the roof and swapping between all of that other thing, all of the other stuff. And by the way, the roof does slot in between the chimney. So the roof does slot in between the chimney. You don't just stop. You still place it in there where you can. So you do want to keep it going straight through the chimney. Like there, you can see that it's actually interweaved straight in there. And we're now just going to, as I keep repeating over and over again, we're just going to get this roof sorted out, and it'll look fantastic once we have finished it. So I'm just going to place all of this, then I'm going to extend this quartz over. This is actually the hardest part, is this row just behind the chimney, because it's hard to get the quartz stairs to place the way that you want them to. They so often try and go like upside down and sideways and stuff. It's really difficult to try and place them. I mean, yeah, see what I mean? It's so hard. I might just, there we go, I've just got to replace that. I might actually use like quartz slabs just for easiness sake, but I would highly recommend that you actually use like quartz there rather than doing what I've done, which is the lazy way. So I'm just going to build this up. I really do dislike doing roofs, by the way. Roofs are definitely the worst part of any tutorial for me. They're so irritating, especially roofs like this, where you've got like chimneys in the way. I wish I would have waited with the chimney. I wish I would have waited to do this until after the fact, and then it would have been nice and easy. We could have just built the chimney directly into the roof, but I did want to get it nice and out of the way just so that we had it done, basically. But there we go, we have just about completed this, and now we can add all of the other stuff to the roof. So can you remember the pattern? I'll remind you. So we begin with the front of the roof. This is a roof on the right. We want to going left, going towards back. We want to move back one, knock out the block. Move back one, or leave a gap of one, knock out the block. Gap of two, knock out the block. Then gap of we then want to have a gap of one, knock out the block. Gap of two, knock out the block. Gap of one, knock out the block. Gap of two, knock out the block. Gap of one, knock out the block. The end blocks are purple wool. The blocks in between are redstone lamps. That's pretty much it. Very, very easy to do this first row. However, we then want to follow this pattern along, and we want to knock out the exact same pattern coming all the way up the roof, except we want to leave rows of one in between. So we want to leave the rows of one in between here, and we then want to, I'm going to knock out this one and that one as well. Even behind the chimney, I'm going to continue the pattern, and we're just going to knock out all of these blocks, and then we'll figure out which blocks go where. It's going to be very, very easy to figure out. The fact that we're using a pattern just makes it so much simpler, guys. It really does. If you want to just randomize it, then you can, but I like using a pattern. So here we go. Here we have the purple wool. So on the next row above, I'm going to start again with red, and then moving backwards, I'm going to have orange, then yellow, then I'm going to pretend that I placed these two here. So I'm going to leave two rows, and then I'm going to move straight to purple. Then I'm going to go back to red and then orange. So do you see, like, if we were able to place the pattern, we'd then use the lime and then the cyan. That's why I've went to purple. And then coming all the way back to the start, I'm going to place an orange, then a yellow, then a lime, and then I can actually place, like, cyan this time and purple. And then I can come back to the start of the pattern, which is red wool, then orange, then yellow. And then I'm going to come all the way to the start again like a typewriter, and I'm going to do yellow, then lime, then cyan, purple, red, orange, yellow, lime. Then for the next row at the start, we're going to have our lime, cyan, purple, red, orange, yellow, green, blue. And that will be that. We now have to put quartz slabs running all the way up the center of the roof from the front to the back. We also want to do upside down quartz stairs underhanging the overhanging part of the roof, except right at the top I'm going to place an upside down, or I'm going to place a quartz slab, and this will allow us to still see the cyan here up at the top. We're now going to move to the front part of the roof, and we're going to do the same thing. So I'm going to place the upside down quartz stairs here. I'm going to place the quartz slab, some quartz stairs, and that will be pretty much the entire build, except we are missing just one thing, guys. We are missing just one thing. We have to flick on the lights that we have on the left-hand side of the roof and the right-hand side of the roof. So here, we just want to place switches behind the lamps. So we just want to place levers, levers, switches, whatever you want to call it, some power source behind each one of the lamps. I like to use the levers rather than just place block redstone there, but that's just me. And this will make it so that these are all nice and lit up. It'll make everywhere look lovely and Christmassy, and I don't think that I need to give you another reason. I think that those are two perfectly valid, wonderful reasons, and that will be the side of the house. And that is pretty much the entire gingerbread house complete. We are missing a couple of things, of course. If you do want to make the house look a little bit nicer from the outside, you might want to add just a few random like walls, kind of like thrown about the place. You might want to just add a few random walls, kind of just thrown around in a random pattern on the ground in front of the house. You might also want to do it all the way around the sides as well. If you like, you can also add lights to your house. This is also using wool. And let's say we're on the front of the house and we're starting right with this bottom quartz block. I'm going to place a red wall to the right of it. Then up left diagonally, I'm going to place an orange. Then coming backwards diagonally to the left, I'm going to place a yellow. Then coming forwards diagonally upwards, I'm going to place a lime. Then upright diagonally, I'm going to place a cyan. So those look like lights that are wrapped around the house. I'm going to do the same pattern on the other side as well. On the front, I'm going to have the red wall, then the orange here, yellow here, then I'm going to come back around, lime, and then cyan. And those look like lights that are kind of like wrapped around the base of the house. And you can do the same pattern on the back as well. So if we come all the way to the back, and the back could actually use it because the back is ever so slightly boring. And once again, the reason that it is boring is because I did want to leave it so that for the inside of the house, this is where you could place a fireplace, or this is where you could place a tree right at the back of the house and right in the center. But there you go. Add some lights to the house. You'll make it look all nice and Christmassy like that. Some other things that you can do to make your house look a little bit nicer is you could add a candy cane out in front of the house. These are so easy to make. Like, you'd start maybe from like a diagonal of the house. So we start with the bottom left-hand corner of the house, so we move out diagonally, and a candy cane can easily be made like block of quartz, red hardened clay, block of quartz, red hardened clay, block of quartz, then like start to pivot it towards you diagonally, so maybe like a red hardened clay, then a block of quartz, red hardened clay, then again a diagonal, and then there you go, and maybe they like move it down by one, and they have a candy cane. Or maybe you just make it two blocks, and then you do like a red hardened clay, then a red hardened clay, and then like a block of quartz, and you can like angle it down, and that's just a nice little candy cane. If you want to make the entrance look a little bit more special, you might want to just like have it sink down into the ground a little bit, maybe use some like oak wood like this. You might want to use some oak wood stairs and place some like oak wood slabs in the center, and that would make the entrance look ever so slightly more special if you wanted to. Let me see here, let's place that, and there we go, there you are. And why have I placed that? You know what, we can use the quartz there instead, and we can just have that, I think maybe just one block further as well, there we go. And we can also have some kind of like in the candy cane pattern, the red and the white, we could have like just moving outwards, maybe just again just to add a little bit more color to the place, this, and then maybe move that there, maybe move this block here. And here we go. And there we have something that looks quite nice. And you could always add lights in between these, but I'm not going to. And the reason why is another way to make your house look nice and Christmassy is you can simply add a nice little bit of snow going all the way around your house. Now, I'm not going to do this. I'm not going to do all of it, but just add a border of snow going around the house. Just make it random. It doesn't have to be in like a nice big circle pattern. It doesn't have to be in a rectangle or a square or any sort of normal pattern. Just use normal snow if nothing's going to melt it. It's important that nothing melts it. And just kind of like go all the way around your house, and we can make it look just a bit nicer. So that's how I achieved the effect of the snow right at the start of the video, and then I obviously just filled it in, and I also just like topped up the snow on the ground, like I made it bigger in certain places, I made it smaller in certain places like this, and you can just go all the way around the house and you can fill it in like that. Plus I also added a Christmas tree to the front right hand side of the house as well, which I'm not going to construct because it does take a little bit longer than usual. It'll take you like 4 minutes or so to make that. But if you want a tutorial for the Christmas tree that you saw at the start of the house, you can actually check it out in the card system and the description below. But, ladies and gentlemen, this is pretty much the entire finished gingerbread house. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this one. I'm not going to be doing the interior for you. That is not what this video is about. We are just focusing on the actual house. I don't want to be delving into interiors. You guys know what you want to do to the inside of that thing. You want to make it nice and Christmassy. If you did enjoy this video, please give it a like. I'd really, really appreciate that. I honestly would. And who knows, maybe this thing will appear at the bottom of your bed tomorrow morning. I don't know. It probably won't. If it doesn't, the dog probably ate it. I'm just saying. So, if you do like the video, please do subscribe to the channel. And if you do subscribe, not only should you say hello down there in the comment section below, do say hello. I'd like to welcome you to the channel. But also do click that little bell next to the subscription button, and that will alert you as to when I post videos. If you do like the content, if you subscribed, if you'd like to, do comment down below. Also, let me know what you want to see next. But if you do want more stuff by me, do check the card system in the description below, and you'll find playlists in there. You'll find all sorts of playlists that will show you how to make all sorts of things. Like, there's loads of them. For instance, there's a suburban house playlist that will show you how to make stuff like this, and stuff like this, and even stuff like this. Like, this is a Barbie pink mansion, which can easily be changed color. We even have a quartz house playlist, so if you want to make more modern designs like that, or that, or potentially even this, then you could easily just check out the quartz house playlist, and you could find all sorts of different tutorials and all sorts of different playlists that will show you how to make all sorts of stuff. And if you don't want to make any more houses for a while, if you're working on, say, a city or something like that, then you could head over to the real world buildings playlist, and it will show you how to make everything that you can see on the ground right now in front of you. This is all my real world stuff that's required or that I like to build in my city. And if we head over here to the public park, this can all be found in my public park playlist. Every single thing that you see on the ground, and I do mean everything, has a tutorial, even including this lovely little eco house that we have here, even including like this hobbit hole and this far more substantial ultimate survival house. Everything can be found in the card system in the description below. Check that all out. If you do, like the video. If you did like it, subscribe to the channel, say hello, suggest what you want to see next. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you have a good Christmas, and I'll see you in the next one.